During day three of the R. Kelly trial, one of the things the jury heard was that the late singer, Aaliyah, illegally married Kelly in Chicago in 1994. For the first time, jurors saw the marriage license for R. Kelly and Aaliyah. At the time, he was 27 of age, and she was 15, but marriage documents falsely said she was 18. Prosecutors called Carolyn Harris, a Cook County court clerk for 21 years, in the department that issues birth, marriage, and death records. She testified that anyone seeking to marry at that time in Cook County had to show valid ID and be at least 18. If they were younger, they had to be accompanied by a parent. The prosecution introduced as evidence the application for marriage, the marriage license, and the certificate of marriage involving Kelly and Aaliyah, all of which were closely examined. She said the bride was listed as Aaliyah D. Horton, with a birth date of January 16, 1976. Aaliyah actually was born on the same date, but in 1979. According to Harris, the type of ID presented for Aaliyah, according to the document, was from the Department of Public Aid. The date of the application was August 30, 1994, and its effective date, meaning the earliest date they could marry, was August 31, 1994. On cross-examination, Harris said she was not the clerk who handled the Kelly and Aaliyah marriage documents in 1994. Later, the prosecution called Demetrius Smith, who described himself as an assistant and tour manager for Kelly between 1984 and 1996. He testified under subpoena and immunity from prosecution. It's reported that Smith turned out to be a cranky witness. He appeared uncooperative on the stand, saying he didn't remember some things that took place. Prosecutors then would remind him of what he said in his grand jury testimony, making him read from a transcript. He was even reprimanded by the judge repeatedly for overtalking her and the prosecutors. At one point, Smith complained that he felt as if he was on trial for Aaliyah. By the end of day, it's said that he was very tense on the stand. He said, "I'm truly uncomfortable with this, Your Honor. We're continuously talking about Aaliyah, and her parents aren't here." This did not sway prosecutors from continuing on with their line of questioning. When he somewhat composed himself and was able to recall events, Smith told a muddling and conflicting story. Under prosecution questioning, Smith claimed that Daryl McDavid, Kelly's accountant and manager, arranged the illegal marriage to Aaliyah. Smith said he thought it was a bad idea because she was underage, but wanted to stay in the loop. So he offered to help get Aaliyah a false ID by bribing a welfare office worker with $500 in cash. He said Aaliyah went with him to the welfare office to have her picture taken for the ID. He said she didn't fill out any paperwork, and the ID did not have her age. Smith said he thought she needed another form of ID. So he described going to a courier-type shipping store to get a work ID. When it came to describing what happened when they went to get the marriage documents, Smith faltered and had to read his own grand jury testimony out loud for everyone to hear. He read that officials at the county clerk's office denied her application because there was no age on her false IDs. But Smith said, McDavid then allegedly stepped in and pulled some strings so they could get a marriage license. He said he didn't really know how McDavid allegedly made that happen. Smith said Aaliyah was the niece of Kelly's then tour manager, Barry Hankerson, who introduced Kelly to her and her family in Detroit so he could hear Aaliyah sing. Smith said Hankerson told him she was 14 or 15 at the time. Later, Kelly became Aaliyah's mentor and the producer and writer of her first album. The name of the album, titled Age Ain't Nothing But a Number, was released in May 1994. Smith described himself becoming concerned about Kelly's too friendly behavior with Aaliyah. Then while on tour with Kelly, the singer would tell him Aaliyah is in trouble and they needed to get home. Smith testified that while on the plane home to Chicago, Kelly told Smith that Aaliyah thinks she's pregnant. He said McDavid was making arrangements for Aaliyah to marry Kelly so that she could protect him. The prosecution would then ask Smith, protection from what? To which Smith replied, I guess jail. The focus on Aaliyah, who died in a 2001 plane crash, is important because prosecutors have charged that Kelly had sexual contact with the singer, known as Jane Doe No. 1 in the indictment, and that she was underage at the time that Kelly believed she became pregnant. Prosecutors argue he secretly arranged the marriage by allegedly getting a member of his entourage to bribe a government official in Chicago. They did this in order to obtain a fake ID, in order to protect himself from criminal charges. Because according to the law, a wife can't be forced to testify against a husband. The outline of the story of Kelly and Aaliyah has long been known. Although Kelly has never admitted to wrongdoing, the marriage was soon annulled. In her opening statement on Wednesday, Kelly's defense lawyer, Nicole Blankbecker, said there is no evidence to prove Aaliyah was pregnant, noting that she obviously cannot testify herself, as she's not alive to do so. Aaliyah, God rest her soul, passed away, Becker would explain to the court. If Mr. Kelly was involved in a crime in 1994, would we be here today? Despite defense efforts to keep it out, U.S. District Judge Ann Donnelly ruled that the issue of the alleged illegal marriage would be allowed in at the trial. She said that it was clearly relevant and it clearly shows a motive for Racketeering Act No. 1, so it is admissible. This is the end of part 1 of day 3 of the R. Kelly trial. Click the next video if you would like to continue with part 2.